It's a pleasure sharing a dais with such eminent people on this dais. And thank you to BLUECON for inviting Ministry of Tourism, Government of India to be a part of this. The role of Ministry of Tourism in this entire subject on which the exhibition and the conference is being held is actually a very minuscule, but economically that's a very impressive aspect of the blue economy. Cruise tourism, of course, is a subject which many of us have been known, but have not really thought about how we can gain maximum out of this one subject. I have joined this ministry in Mumbai in the year 1983-84. Since then, I have been watching, and we have been involved in the cruise tourism promotion, promoting cruise tourism, also assisting cruises when they dock in Mumbai. The number of cruises then used to be more than 100 a year, touching Mumbai port. That went down after the unfortunate incidents in Mumbai to almost 50, 40, 30. There was a stage when it was perceived that cruise tourism is going to finish and nobody will touch Mumbai henceforth. But thanks to the visionaries we have in our country, thanks to the Minister, Honorable Nitin Gadkari ji, who pushed this sector so much. So jointly, Ministry of Shipping and Ministry of Tourism formed a cruise tourism task force. This task force was badly needed because we needed the required infrastructure, the required environment to bring in more number of cruises to the country. And that is when the cruise tourism task force sat together and decided that how we are going to bring more number of cruises to India. How we are going to bring more number of cruises not only to Mumbai port. We have 5 ports which cater to the cruises: Mumbai, Chennai, Cochin, Mangalore and Goa. So all the ports came into limelight with this task force. They were part of this task force in addition to the major ministries that play major role, like Bureau of Immigration, Ministry of External Affairs, Home Affairs, Shipping, Tourism, and the, of course, private stakeholders in the those who are involved in this cruise tourism business. Together, the cruise tourism task force sat and deliberated a lot on how we can bring this sector to a thriving sector. I'm sure today, if you compare from last, say, 10 years or 20 years, the figure of cruise tourists arriving into Mumbai or to India was 1 lakh. In about 2 years' time, that has become 2 lakhs. So see the growth and the difference that it has made to the economy. The cruise tourism task force, firstly, it was what they decided that we didn't have a standard operating procedure. For any of the ports, the crews would come, we would assist them, the passengers would get down. There would be passengers who would do Golden Triangle tour from Mumbai and join in the next port. But when they were doing all this, there was no method in what was happening. The travel agents, tour operators, the shipping agents would do their best to see to it that they get required visa. They would see to it that they get required permission to enter the port. At times, the group used to get stranded outside the port area because they did not have permission to get inside the port. So there were many things that were affecting this industry. So first thing which was decided was, let us ease the visa process. So the e-visa was brought in for cruise tourism. The second thing was the biometrics. If you are giving them e-visa, where would the tourists do biometrics? Because at the airport, it's so easy, you get your biometrics done at the counter. But at cruise tourism, they don't get advance intimation. So it became difficult. That was waived. I mean, that was biggest move that Bureau of Immigration and Home Ministry has given to the cruise industry. After that, the standard operating procedures put pressure on the port authorities on giving priority to the cruise tourism operations. We all know that cargo is a major revenue generator for us, but cruise tourism is equally major tourism generation for us. So basically, there are these small things which were put together and the SOPs were launched. Once these SOPs were adopted by the port authorities, things started falling in place. And now the number from 50, 40, it has gone again back to 75 to 80. We are receiving cruise liners in big number to Mumbai. We are receiving cruise liners in big number to Goa and, of course, Cochin. This office from where I come is Ministry of Tourism's office in Mumbai, which looks after the states of Goa, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Chhattisgarh, with Dadra Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu. Interestingly, the cruises also have interest visiting Porbandar to put it on their itinerary. And what happened when we realized that the ports do not have the required infrastructure of international standards? I mean, we know that the cruises around Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, and how they cater to the cruise tourism passengers. We did not have that kind of facilities. Ministry of Tourism launched a scheme under which it funds the port authorities and also the state governments. Port authorities for bringing in the required infrastructure to cater to these international standards requirement, and the state governments to develop the peripheral requirement of the ports. Once a tourist lands, if the tourist is here for 24 hours, he is definitely going into the city to see the sights or to see the attractions. I mean, I remember my days when we handled tourists in 83 and 84, the attraction for tourists was going for a lunch to Taj Mahal Hotel, the old Taj Wing, going for dinner to some other hotel which was very exclusive restaurant. But now things have changed. Now they have many, many things. There are almost 40 different packages for Mumbai alone. I mean, there is a tour which only takes them to Banganga. There is a tour which takes them to show them the old Khotachi Wadi, if anybody has heard of this area, or the Mazgaon docks, to showcase these very unique points. There is a tour Mumbai by dawn. How Mumbai changes its scenario from dawn to dusk, that is something very interesting. So all these have been put together. The task force had also appointed international consultant to give us the feedback on what is required, what India should do to bring in more tourists. So they have given their recommendations, which Ministry of Shipping and Tourism together have accepted and are continuously working on it. I think, Abhijit, if there is anything more that you would want me to talk, I will definitely be here for some more time. But
thank you, ma'am, for a small capsule of what the task force is all about.